Bonjour, bonjour, fragrance lovers. This is Clémence. I talk about fragrance. Et welcome back. In today's video, I'm showing you a new collection from Roja Parfum. I'm really excited because I never tried properly before Roja, and this is actually my first bottle of Roja that I ever had. So I'm super glad to introduce to you more the brand and also the new collection. So they basically launched a new collection that is called the Essence de Parfum Collection for Women. Roja have been really nice to send me the sample of the collection, and I also have a bottle of Danger. Will give you my first impression, and if I like them, you will see them more in top list or anything like this, and hopefully I will like it. But you know, I'm gonna be like totally transparent with you, as usual. You know me. Anyway, I hope I'm gonna like it. I'm gonna first start with the one I have, which is Danger Essence de Parfum. So I've tried this one since a few days now, and I'm really, really delighted. You know. Absolutely love this one. It's mainly like floral note, but very creamy floral. And with the thyme as well, I can really smell a little bit of that peachy note. So it's really beautiful, really elegant. It's got like a trail that is quite much more warmer and oriental, with like a sandalwood and creamy vanilla. So it's for someone that wants something, I would say, super elegant, and want to charm someone without being too much intoxicating, you know. I feel it's really elegant, and the opening is actually quite citrusy, like effervescent, very fizzy. So actually there were aldehydes in the fragrance because it's so fizzy. Really feminine, a very sensual vibe, probably something I would wear on a date. You can really smell the quality of ingredient. It's absolutely crazy, the quality, and that was my first impression. I was like, whoa, these flowers. I've checked the website, and it's rose de mer and jasmine from Grasse. So Grasse, you know, is the cradle of perfumery. If you follow my Fragrance Academy series, you will know that this is where soil is the best to grow the flower, and this is one of the most quality flower you could get in the world. Is in smell this slightly oni, much more creamy tone of the flower, and I could really smell that in there. Definitely gonna wear it on special occasion, I'm telling you. It's nearly like something elegant, but with a, you know, dangerous kind of vibe. Well, it's the name, but yeah. Okay, so now I've got the little sample in the set of the whole collection of Essence de Parfum. So I'm gonna try it with you and give you my honest first impression. I hope I'm gonna like it. I've got my pen to write some notes, and let's go for the collection. Okay, so the first one is called Scandal. I hope it's gonna be very scandalous. If I refer by the name, something I would wear more for night out, if you see what I mean. But Uber Eats, it's on the way. Amazing, my food is arriving. Great! I'm filming after work. If I do a video, I definitely don't have time to cook something, so I'm waiting for the food to arrive. So okay, so Scandal. Slightly honeyed, very white flowers as well. It's like very fresh bouquet of flower to me. Flower that are very delicate, nearly like something like Lily of the Valley or something. There's some kind of a fruit in there, but it's really delicate. I like that. It's romantic to me, actually. Creamy white floral, tuberose and gardenia. If you like gardenia from Chanel, you're gonna like that. Quite powdery, that's what I could smell as well. It's creamy, but it's freshest than the Danger. Lily of the Valley, yes! Oh, my nose is good! Beautiful, it's really nice for daytime. Then we have Reckless. Oh, much more warmer in there. They're still all open in something quite fresh, which is nice. This one's got like kind of a spice. Wait, sweet, warm, soft powder. Yeah, it's much more sweeter, this one, compared to the other one, more floral. I really like this one, it's got a crush, like something sweet and fruity at the same time. an orangey tone, but much more sweeter and soft. Playful. I love this. I really love that. Yeah, there's coriander. That's what I thought. Pink pepper, coriander, so a bit more spicy. But well, that is for a character that is a bit more, you know. The florals are stunning. And this touch of sugar. And it's not like a heavy sweet. It's quite like a enveloping, mysterious sweetness. A bit more younger for this one. Let's try risqué. Is that risqué? Is it in French? Yeah, risqué. That's nice. Oh. Oh, yeah, that's definitely much more risqué. Oh, that's my vibe. Do you know what? This one smells vintage. Ultimate vintage scent. Oh, there's some green flowers. Green notes in there. Oh, I love that. But it's much more greener, flowery, but greener at the same time. All of those ones are very rich. It's not too heavy because there's nicely balanced. Oh, this is intoxicating though. All of them are super feminine. They encapsulate the essence of a lady, like very ladylike. It's really nice. Yeah, it's a chyprée. Good nose, Clémence. I don't know if you know what's a chyprée, but it's usually a bit more leathery with a vibrant citrus, and that was really popular back in the days, actually, in the 70s and anything like that. But chyprée comes back in waves now. That's a very modern chyprée though. Hyacinthe. Yeah, that's the green flower I was looking for. Hyacinthe always have like a green touch aspect, very powdery. Chamomile. Ah, yeah, it's very soothing at the same time. Oh, that's beautiful. It's nearly like a tea time fragrance. I'm going to a place that is a bit more posh. Like, I would probably wear that.
We have Elixir. Is that this? Yes, Elixir.
Oh. They basically have done a lot of version of flowery fragrance, like they mastered the florals note, but in all different way. The same ingredient coming back, like rose de mer, jasmine, fin grass, but they all mastered differently, giving you a different vibe for a different occasion. I'm impressed by the quality, by the way. Like, the ingredients are just so refined. And there's raspberry, so if you like those kind of notes, you might like this. You know, this makes me think more of something like, if you like Mont Guerlain, or if you like Mont Paris, or if you like things like that, you're gonna like that very much. But much more refined, obviously, to be honest. Amber. Violet as well. So it's nearly like, you know, the bonbon in violet. Like, don't know if you ever tried those bonbons. It smells a bit like that on the back, but it's not too much. It's kind of a lipstick fragrance to me, this. Very luminous.
51.
Bit more special to me. More character. Amazing. Got the wine. Sorry, interruption. It's very velvety.
You know, I can see the whole kind of same ingredient coming back, but
it's totally different when I smell them.
This is nice. Like, I can smell more cinnamon, more spices like this. Like a proper oriental fragrance, you know.
It's more waxy note and more woods.
And then we have Enigma. There's none that I disliked for now, so I'm really happy. I actually really enjoy them. Where is my pen? I'm sitting on it. There
it is. Oh, it's very powdery, this one. Musky. I can smell musk. It's like clean flowers. Like, you know, when it smells so clean and like a cloud. It smells like a beauty product to me. So nice. It's very mysterious.
Unveil the mystery.
I should have write those things.
Soft and powdery, yeah. Tell me there's musk so I don't look stupid.
Yes, there's musk. But I think they all got musk.
Ambergris as well. Yeah. And I can really smell the peach as well in there.
You know when the days that you want to have something very elegant, but you really want to smell just soft, clean. I go for musky smell when I don't want anything too fragrance-like. For example, flowery or too intense. So that could be quite nice for office as well. Go through them again and give you my final first impression. And this is probably the ultimate elegant fragrance for women that is in this collection. Like, honestly, if you want to treat yourself to something ultra luxurious, super refined, and rich with super qualitative ingredient, that's definitely the collection you need to go for. Scandal. That is pulsing still. I will definitely like go on a professional
kind of meeting. It's boosting confidence, this one. Super romantic. Actually, I don't know if I would wear that on a wedding as well. Reckless is more spicy, warmer, slightly honeyed. Something for me to go out. Risqué is the most vintage one. Compared to the other one, it's a bit more mature. But I would wear that personally a lot. That's really my vibe. Ladylike kind of touch. It's greener. So strong. Stunning. I love that. Elixir is more sweeter. Playful. I would say it's the youngest one out of all. Really feminine. Like, compared to the other one, it's more red fruit in there. Modern woman. 51 is the softest out of all. It smells so velvety. It's like touching like a velvet sofa. Oh, exactly like that, actually. Yes! Warm, sensual. That and Danger for a date are amazing. Enigma is the most mysterious one because the accords that in is there are so special, but it's the cleanest out of all. Really stands out, to be honest, with this musky tone. So overall, it's like they mastered again the floral tone, which I really, really enjoy. And honestly, this collection is just a beauty. It's a little jewel. For a man, if you want to treat your lady with something absolutely outstanding and super feminine, you're gonna so enjoy that. For me, I would say my favorite one are definitely number 51 because of the velvety touch. I really love Reckless too as well, but more honeyed, slightly more provocative. I'm intrigued by the 51. 51 here. Where is my risque? The risque one is basically like a number 5, but really modernized. The 51 on the skin. Oh, it's stunning. So good. It's really like much more warmer, like nearly vanilla-like. Let me try Reckless over here. Elixir there. The Reckless one. The Reckless and 51 for me are like winners. I love 51. Reckless. The Reckless is more honeyed. Oh. Oh. So I hope you enjoyed the video. Let me know if you have the occasion to try in the future the collection. I will be very happy to see your impression, and also tell me if you're curious to try. And yeah, just leave me a little like, and I will see you very, very soon. Bye now.